Gosling, Christian Bale, and Steve Carell. Talk about anyway. I gotta say though, what did you guys think? What did you all think when you actually got to see the movie for the first time as it was complete? I mean, I feel like so many of us, we finally get what happened here. Let's start with you, Ryan.
What I thought when I first saw the film?
Yeah.
I think it's really unique, and I just feel like it speaks to Adam McKay's credit because. You know, I'm a huge fan of his anyway, and his movies are like, not even movies, they're more like friends of mine. You know, I'll just check in with Step Brothers just to see how it's doing, or Anchorman, and so, you know, I feel differently about his movies, and not just because they're comedies, I just, like, I love them. And so, I wanted to work with him anyway, and then having the opportunity to work on something like this, which is such a departure for him, was really interesting, and I just felt like, you know, his intentions in making this movie were so good. You know, he's freakishly smart, but he's very passionate, and he really wanted to share his knowledge about this. And I feel like, thank God he did, because he has a way of doing it that is so unique to him. It's like he has his own touch, and in the hands of a lot of other filmmakers, it could have been, you know, much more heavy-handed and sort of judgmental, but you never, I think, as an audience, feel judged.
I want to talk about, I mean, Adam McKay has done so many great comedies that we all love, like Step Brothers, The Other Guys, and of course, Anchorman. I mean, come on, let's stay classy, Los Angeles. But for him to take such a big step with a more serious film that still has humor, but the way it was structured, with breaking the fourth wall, I mean, with all of you working with him, like, did he seem to be, like, rejuvenated by getting a chance to do something different? What do you think of that, Steve?
You're implying that he needed rejuvenation. No, it was a similar experience working on this, because he is very smart, as he was on Anchorman. He's incredibly funny, but I think what separated this movie is that he's incredibly passionate about the subject matter and has a great understanding of it and felt that he had something to say. And I think he said it within this movie.
Well, Adepero, I mean, working with these great actors, I mean, you're a strong woman in a film surrounded by a bunch of weird guys. I mean, what was it like to be part of this great ensemble?
It was just really, really inspiring, and I was super geeked to get to work with Steve. Super geeked, actually, it was really great just watching them work, because a lot of the scenes, I may be, you know, to the side and just getting to see the dynamics of all the actors. Was really, really inspiring, and then seeing the final product, it was refreshing and inspired filmmaking, and it made me really excited about film again. So, it's always wonderful to be a part of something that makes me feel that way, and hopefully makes other people feel that way.
Definitely, go ahead, Christian.
You've got one of the, I think, the best lines in the whole film. Did everyone just see the film?
Yeah.
There's when you say, I think it's 15 billion. Right, yeah. Which I just think is such a wonderful moment, because I've never before in a film had a number get me choked up and get goosebumps, you know? But it was just fantastic. The way you said 15 minutes.
Acting. We were talking about this outside just now, and, you know, the structure of the film, like when you read the script and, you know, you saw the way that that Adam and his co-writer, Charles Randolph, took Michael Lewis's book and just made it so accessible. Like, what was it? What were you thinking when you read the screenplay and going, like, people are really going to get this?
Yeah, I mean, I read Charles's screenplay originally, which was incredible and dense and and sort of the foundation for what we did. And then Adam brought this layer to it that really made it sort of airborne and really accessible and opened it up to include the audience. My mother saw it last night and she said she felt like someone was sitting, you know, next to her whispering and sort of taking her through it. I guess it was Ryan whispering.
But had a great time. I hope she calls.
I think he really cracked it open, and took something and really elevated it, and I was struck last night by how personal the movie is. I think from him that you know, when Steve says, there's a moment in the film where Steve says, "I thought we were better than that." I kind of felt like Adam just really urgently and with his sort of quiet outrage needed to tell this story.
Well, I absolutely wanted to ask about that too. And Steve, we were just talking about this a little bit outside too, about how, you know, the characters are so fully realized, they're dynamic, and there is a big moral compass going on in a film like this versus like Wall Street or Wolf of Wall Street or Margin Call, which, you know, big business films, especially Margin Call, is covered so much subject matter. But again, you know, to play these vulnerable characters, how much contact did each of you have with your real life counterparts? So Christian, actually, I want to start with you on that one.
You know, I spoke with Adam, and then I looked at online material of Mike Burry, and then I went up and met with him in his office, and we spent the whole day just sitting there in his office. We talked for like 8 or 9 hours straight. A wonderful conversation. He's an incredibly intelligent man. I desperately tried to keep up with what he was talking about, but most importantly, on a very human level, I grew to like the man a great deal. He's someone who's got not only a brilliant mind, but a fantastic heart in terms of the consequences of what happens with this market and the way that it's set up. There's the obvious things, and you get to study mannerisms, etc. With it. And Mike came and visited the set. He was around, and he's going to be seeing the film in New York, so I'll hear what he thinks of it.
How about you, Steve?
I spent the same amount of time with Michael Burry, and it really screwed me up because I played a different character. It was Dave, this man. Same thing. Incredibly articulate, smart. And then I met the guy I was portraying, and my head blew up. It was similar. I spent a day, and we went out to breakfast, and then he invited me over to his apartment, and I met his wife and met his kids, and just very casual. And it's a weird situation when you meet someone like that, because you don't want to feel like you're examining someone for an experiment at like, why did you do it this way, and how do you move your finger like that? You know, it's because you don't want to be creepy, but at the same time, you're observing and you're trying to glean as much as you can without seeming like you are. You're just trying to absorb as much of them as you can in sort of a normal way. But he was very forthcoming and very kind, very gracious and generous. He actually came to set a few times as well, which is odd on your first day of shooting to have the person you're portraying standing at the monitor and watching.
He walked up to me and said, "You look nothing like Vinny."
Yeah, he's very outspoken, a very unfiltered sort of person. But again, very generous.
You know, the movie's so visceral and vital and ingenious in the structure that it occurred to me until I was halfway home that, Christian, you are not in any scenes with these fine folks here. And what was it like to sort of film the movie on your own like that? How fast did you film your scenes, and what did you think when you saw it all put together?
We filmed very, very fast, because when it's just one man in an office with dialogue, you can film very bloody quickly. I loved it. I love just being by myself and shooting. It's a good way to work. I'd recommend it for anyone. You pack so much in, and then the film also said, you know, Adam tends to work with a mic. And so then you sort of get the voice of God, you know, appear in the office telling you your crap or whatever it is, or whatever very funny thing he's doing to try to make me crack up during the take. But really interested in that case to see the final result of the film, because I had no idea about any of the rest of it whatsoever. And they're also bloody fantastic. It's really, really very proud to be a part of it. It was so much better than I expected it to be.
Wow. did you meet before the premiere last night, or did you just all sort of...
I had met Ryan briefly. I met Steve last night. Jeremy last night.
Wow.
And Adam last night as well. Yeah, I just heard him on the microphone before that.
because Adam McKay does come from a comedy background, he was broke for SNL, a lot of improv. How much improv did he encourage for this movie, or was it like, no, stick to the script?
No, he expected a lot of it, and it's difficult because the language is so dense and so complicated and so specific, so to be able to sort of, you know, improvise on that level was a whole other, you know, was a whole other experience. You know, he would just yell out through a microphone and just go like, you know, like, hey Ryan, you know, just you know, lay into him about your negative carry, go ahead. Right now? Yeah, just hit him. Hit him about your negative carry. Go for it. He expects you to have something in your pocket and be ready to play that way.
Wow. Is that nerve-wracking, or is that like exhilarating to sort of go by, you know, have that kind of mood and direction and encouragement from a director?
It's awful. Well, it was like cramming for a test every night, you know, I think.
Oh, wow.
I mean, and all of us were just sort of trying to share information. I mean, Strong was the only, I mean, you're a financial analyst right now, aren't you? I mean, but Strong actually he really learned this stuff. I mean, he didn't learn how to remember it. He really learned it. It was really impressive.
Where
tell everybody how it works.
the other thing I got from the film, I mean, it was so much. I mean, I just felt like I kept shaking my head, like going, oh, okay. Oh, I mean, like how great when you saw the film. Just to sort of spell it out for you, Margot Robbie.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that was like a genius approach.
What?
Margot Robbie,
yeah.
In a bathtub. What's not to love about that? I'm just sort of rambling. You know, she just sort of caught me off guard. But you know, Jeremy, you know, when you're working on a film that has a fast pace like this does, I mean, does the filming sort of go fast? I mean, how long was like principal photography for like the majority of the scenes with the four of you?
I mean, I don't know. I felt like we had time to spend in the scenes, and I kind of felt like we were always just rehearsing, which is a great way to feel when you're working. And the way Barry Aykroyd shot the movie, you didn't really feel the scrutiny of the camera. You didn't really know where the camera was, so it was very free. The environment